Jay Shrek.
And James.
You know, welcome to part two. We've had a lot of discussion. You can say discussion, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Before you go on to part two, the only thing I would ask is that you go back to one, right? You go through all of one, and then you read the description of the article about what got us on this journey to begin with, right?
Yeah, you need to see the article before you can really decide what you think about us.
Because we're here at Oak Flats, and what you need to do is realize why we started here, and you will understand that as we go through this. You'll understand why we started at this location. So the first thing that we did after James called me is we deducted the site, right? So we realized two things. Why did it say 5 miles from Oak Flat? Why did it say that? Because we knew from being out here a long time that 5 miles west would be Superior. And if it was in Superior, we'd already known about it. And so we decided that that was a ploy, maybe a trick to hide it, and that maybe it was up here in Oak Flat because this is such sacred grounds. And there's a reason that the Apache used to come through here because of the acorns. So they spent a lot of time here.
So we started work in Oak Flat. We did a basic survey from the campground on up towards Magma Mine off the road there. And basically literally just started scouting. We had the glass out and we were just looking for areas that seemed like they could be where someone had once lived. We went out towards the road here. We went across the way and we spotted some rock walls, and that really started our interest that this could be something legitimate. Again, it's based off one little article that gave us very little information. So we started across the highway there at the what turned out to be a giant wall that went all the way up the mountainside, and worked from there. So we had about this 5 mile radius that we were trying to define what could and couldn't be. And you know, the journey kind of took us from there. We did a little bit more research, found no other articles, no other information, no other maps or directions, Google Earth, the whole deal. And you know, that's when the story really kind of enveloped. That.
So just to let you know what goes on, you know, a lot of times people say, well, don't tell anybody about this ruin. Well, hell, here's the government that found this ruin, right? And they're trying to hide it. The one article is all we've been able to find on this, is one article. And so this is intriguing. And what we're doing is, I can't tell you we're gonna find anything today, but we're gonna keep looking. Mm-hmm. But this is really an incredible story. And you know, just to tell people that, are there still stuff like this around? Hell yes, there is, right?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
So how excited, man, I'm stoked. Let's go find something, James.
Let's keep looking, man.
I mean, maybe though, you know, they're talking bridge too. You know, maybe they're not talking like, you know what I'm saying? You know, maybe mentally trying to think, why would that be there, James? Unless it's some kind of marker for...
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, let's investigate. I have no idea.
Okay, where...
You can go straight through it there and maybe get on the other side of that rock.
I think I'll try brown.
Through the manzanita here?
I think so.
It doesn't look very stable.
Northwest, it's some type of
like
post. Yeah, survey post.
It says something. But
man, that dude's old.
Number 43, it's got like a serial number here on my side.
Northwest. So what we're gonna do is, we've noticed these stone walls. And we're just trying to figure out if these stone walls have anything to do with maybe foundations of ruins. And so we're gonna run on this side of the highway real quick, take a look.
Better for you.
Well, so did I, but you know what happened was they twisted the leg.
Well, yeah, the support thing is not good for you.
These actually feel 20 times better. Kind of funny how this is a little dense through here, you know.
Well, it's definitely like all overgrown. no one comes through here from this angle.
Well, there's the wall. Is that the same wall?
I think it's all part of the same stuff.
Some animal would have been down through here. Something's bed down in there.
Yeah, there's deer back here. And that's why there's hunting from the U.S. Forest Service. Or Game and Fish.
So there's a nice shot of another one of those walls that come through here. And I think that's the one we were looking at. Those boulders look a little rounder, a little smaller. Maybe they had a little more difficult time finding huge, huge boulders on this little wall here. But it's kind of funny. Some of this is barbed wire, you know, some of it is rock. It's amazing how that actually looks like a trail over there, doesn't
it? Yeah, the one on the other side of it.
Why don't you take a look at that?
Yeah.
I don't think it's anything, though.
We'll see.
Just stand up on that ledge, James, and see if you see, you know, up on that next level.
Yeah.
See if there's anything over it in that. And does that wall run down into the creek?
No. And it doesn't seem to pick up on the other side either, which I was thinking of me.
You know, it's hard to say. Look, James. I can't move this shit. This is ancient bowling. So if they weren't afraid of the kind of stuff, they weren't afraid of this shit. This is an incredible place, though. This is. I'm telling you what, this is one of my favorite places. Tell you, we ran into some cable. Kind of, it's bigger than speaker cable, but it's not like, it'd be like a household cable. And we saw a ball of it down there, and it runs down this hill, and I'm just fascinated by what the hell it is. I mean, we're in the middle of nowhere on trails that used to maybe be trails, but there's not been anybody on these trails, James. How long? I mean,
I don't know,
forever.
A long time, 'cause there's no clearance. We just came through all of this behind us, and I mean, at least this year no one's walked down this thing in a while,
man. I you know, it's,
I don't see footprints, I don't see paths cleared.
Why in the hell would there be cable? You know, I've heard of cable that they run to electrify the ground to see if there's minerals, but then they shouldn't be doing that, because this is not mine land, as far as I know. It's forest land. So,
forest land right now.
And then again, if they'd have been doing that, they'd have picked it up, because it'd be like, you know, they wouldn't want to get caught. Now, if the old 60 was going to be parallel on the new 60, and then the new 60 on top of that, how crazy is that? Because you've got the old 60 we're on, you've got the new 60, but then they're supposed to expand it out, so that would almost take it back to the old 60. Does that make sense? You know? So it's, there's only so much room in this valley. So where would they have bumped into this? Would it be closer to over there? I mean, they're not going to go through that wall, right? So if it's over here, just, you know, this is what's kind of just, it's also intriguing. I love, it's a big puzzle. That's what I do love about it. I'm not frustrated at all, believe it or not. I'm excited to try to figure this out, because you don't get your own Lost Dutchman, right? You just don't, right? This is our Lost Dutchman right here. So a little trivia, if you're out and you want to try to find some stuff, find the Oak Flat Dam sign that we just put on there, right? Find that. Tell me where that's at. Where is the Oak Flat Dam rock written in the concrete? Good luck. You know, James, we've taken a long journey and we spent a lot of time, even though, you know, it was only one day, we put a lot of miles in, didn't we?
Yeah, it was pretty much an all-day adventure.
So even though we thought that, you know, it was going to be a long, arduous journey, what we found out was, now, if you look in those trees, from what I could see, James, and I might be wrong on this, but what I saw was, this looked like that rim of trees in the background. Does that look accurate to you?
Yep.
From that picture? So that would mean that a lot of the ruin type stuff would have been right in here, right?
My thoughts are that we're standing on what used to be.
The ruins right here, right? And this would be more of like,
back behind you there.
And these would be more of like the back wall over here. Is that,
yeah, possibly, or it cut right through it and extended through here.
So we went through all this area. Across. So now that you've been through this, you know, what do you think? I mean, here we are, we're standing here, and what do you think about this whole deal now? What's your thoughts? What's your, you know, insight?
Mine?
Yeah.
My insight is that, you know, this wasn't one of the, you know, known sites when they uncovered it. There was already stuff going on, and they weren't going to stop what they were doing when they found it.
So where does this lay out in your mind when they talk about, don't let anybody know about this ancient site because somebody will destroy it? And then what do you think when they find ancient sites and they destroy them? And this was burial grounds though too. That's a bigger deal to me than just ruins, right?
Absolutely.
This was burial grounds.
Well,
right?
I think that's what upset some people, the concept that this was like still burial grounds. And the reality is that this stuff was dug up and given to the Gila River Reservation. I mean, when I say stuff, that's almost insensitive, because the reality is it's the remains of human beings. And then it was basically get those out of our way so we can keep doing what we gotta do.
And then they took a lot of the pottery and things like that, all the stuff that they dug up, right?
Yep.
That they could easily get, and they took it to
U of A,
right?
Yep.
And I'm told they're in like warehouses, and I don't know that to be true though.
Yeah.
You know, I was told that. I was told that, but I can't verify and tell you that that stuff's somewhere else. Why they didn't keep it in Superior, I don't know that either. You know, why they didn't put it in a building somewhere else, I don't know that either. You know, I don't get it either. But it just seems funny that after this journey and everybody, all the stuff that's went on the internet about all of these lost ruins, and we gotta, and I get that. We do have to protect the ones that we have, but so if you're buried, it doesn't matter? Is that kind of what we're looking at, James?
Yeah, I guess the idea would be if you don't know about it, you don't know about it, so don't worry about it. But it seems like if this was something that people were visiting regularly, maybe this wouldn't be a parking lot.
But then again, you know, there are some great ruins in Globe, too, and do people go to those? So is this how we went through last time, or did we go around?
We kind of cut through.
Because this is a spring here, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then this is the wall. That's the actual wall through there, all the way back. It runs down here, almost like a reservoir or even a dam, right?
Kind of, yeah. It's like, I mean, it's basically so cool up back when this spring was running more. It's always still damp down there. You can't really see very well on camera, but. Just on the other side of us is the highway and the bypass in the town.
Did we actually see anything over here other than
scattered throughout all of this area is, you know, pottery fragments. You know, we showed a little bit on the other pictures you saw. Rock.
So I don't know how far this came out this way. You know, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, what we've been able to find through research, it's not really well documented what it did look like. That's the unfortunate thing.
Hey, James. Hey, when you think about hiking 5 miles in, James, right?
Yeah.
And going through all the, and bushwhacking and whacking stuff. And then you're like, well, let's go look for missing Indian ruins at a church in the grass. And it's right there. And the first thought I thought was, why did they have to let that go? I mean, we found the foundation, we found charge, we found everything here, and we're in church. We're we're up at Apache Leap. I mean, we're in town, we're in grass, and we're looking for Indian ruins. And you know what? Right across that grove, they're standing right there. And if you've been here, you went by these ruins 100 times, and you never knew they were there. Jace Reckon, James on the trail. Lost ruins. So we have deducted the journey, and we've come to the Mormon church, right, James?
Yes.
And we're told that this is where the village was. So this whole cat and mouse game we've played, the good news is we found it. The bad news is it wasn't the journey we thought it was going to be, but it still is pretty incredible that it was up here on this peak that it was where the Indian village was.
That's what we're being told.
So I don't know if that means that we're told that there's all kinds of remnants left, but you wouldn't think of an Indian village in the middle of,
Still bushwhacking.
We even bushwhack when we're at the church, right?
We're like well within city limits.
Okay, there's a wall there.
Ah.
So here we are. Wow, look at this now. So we have found the Indian village. There it is. There's the foundation. And so who would have thought at the top of this mound is an Indian village, ancient Indian village? Who would ever have thought that? So we have found So, when you come into Superior and you see the sign on the hill, there it is right there, realize that you are looking at an historical village. imagined this, James, in a million years. Okay, you want to see something weird? Does that look like a arrowhead?
Sort of, yeah.
Well, look.
Oh, yeah, it could be. They could be tiny like that, I suppose.
That's been built. Well, we'll leave that alone. We don't want to get cursed. You know, right there, we just looked at and just came up here and saw that. Isn't that amazing how you go and you look and then you find ancient ruins in a church park, a Mormon church parking lot? Is that not bizarre? I mean, and I don't know, maybe everybody knew this was here. Maybe we're the only ones that didn't realize that this was here. But we have a picture of the excavation of this spot. So we do have a picture of the original excavation of this spot to prove that it's what it was. And supposedly all kinds of stuff came out of this.
It got shipped out to U of A, right?
Yes. Thought maybe that was the foundation there. There's rocks over there, it's hard to see. There's a ditch that runs along there, but I don't know if that's theirs or they covered it up or.
Yeah, it looks like it is part of a rock wall, but maybe it's been broken down since they did so much. We need more.
Yes, it's all over.
Well, that one's actually really interesting. It's got like perlite or pyrite in it or something.
Oh yeah, look at
like
that.
Glittering. That's legit, for sure.
That is legit, right there.
That's really neat.
And just laying around out here.
I mean, yeah, this stuff has literally been like dug up from the excavation and then... and then just kind of finds its way back in.
See, you know, when you're looking at lost treasures and lost cultures, who would have thought? Look, show where we're at, James.
Yeah, I'm gonna give a pan here.
Look, there's Circle K. So, you know, you don't even got to get, you know, you do got to do a little bushwhacking, but.
That's the Highway 60 right there.
There's another piece that looks really interesting.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Like, there's stuff everywhere.
You know, after this long day, man, I don't know how to feel, James. There's so many people that try to think that they want to save this stuff, and I get that, and I want to save it too. But then again, here we are, you know, we're sitting in this parking lot of this church, and not that the church doesn't have a right to have it. But evidently, I mean, what I'm looking at, what it feels like to me is that all this area right in here, you know, was ruins. And maybe this was here before, I don't know. But all I know is it seems really funny that everybody, it's so important to save this stuff, but then when you find it, what'd you do with it? You know? The fact that this was a natural spring is a pretty cool deal to me. It's not running now, but I think that's a pretty cool deal in itself. So I just, I don't know, I'm a little saddened to be honest with you, James. I'm a little sad about this because, you know, here's something we found, but we got rid of it. And, you know, again, that what would we have done with it? Maybe there's nothing we could have done. But, you know, that doesn't lessen my sadness. It really doesn't.
Not at all. It's actually really depressing when we got here.
So I guess we told everybody where ancient ruins are. So I guess that makes us bad. So I guess we're bad.
If you do come visit them, don't do any damage to them, you know? Just take care of them, I guess, as best you can. Also, be careful on the lawn, the well-manicured lawn.